Hi everyone, I'm Aastha Bhatt. I'm Quality Assurance Engineer in QA Engineer. Today I'm going to give demo on the topic black box testing. As already we have discussed on the types, different types of testing, levels of testing, but when we talk about what are the basic manuals, you can say in types of manuals in testing, it is mainly white box testing, black box testing, and gray box testing. So today we will going to discuss what is black box testing first. So what is black box testing? Black box testing is defined as a testing technique in which functionality of the application under test, which is known as AUT, is tested without looking at the internal code structure, implementation details, and knowledge of internal parts of the software. So in simple words, we can say black box testing is a technique of a software testing, which is also known as behavior testing, in which the internal structure or design or implementation of the item being testing is not known to the tester. The primary source of black box testing is a specification of requirements that is stated by the customer only. This method is named so because of the software program in the eyes of the tester is like a black box inside which one cannot see. As the name, it is a black box, so whole the box is black so that outsider cannot see. So without knowing any of the internal structure, the testing is being done. So testing either functional or non-functional without reference to the internal structure of the component or a system. Now comes methods of black box testing. There are different methods in which we can do the black box testing. It can be either functional testing or non-functional testing depending on the functions. In this method, tester selects a function and gives input value to examine its functionality and checks whether the function is giving expected output or not. If the function produces correct output, then it is passed in testing, otherwise failed. The test team reports the result to the development team and then tests the next function. Like in the picture, we can see input is there, output is there, and then the executable program. In this method, we find errors in different categories. We can say in interface errors, in incorrect or missing functions, in behavior or performance errors. So we all these methods help us to find the errors in this. It can be in any of the techniques, either be it we can say functional technique or non-functional technique. But there are set of methods or we can say set of categories in which black box testing helps us, like interface errors or behavior or performance errors. How we do black box testing? It is seven main methods. First is examine specification and requirements in the beginning stage. It is the very foremost step in the black box testing. We examine all the specification and requirements in the very first beginning stage only. Then is choosing valid inputs involving positive and negative test scenarios. We create the test scenarios and either it should be an any positive test scenario by executing the test or a negative test scenarios. Then comes the third step, determining expected output based on the given output. Like in the previous diagram, it is showed like what is the expected output when we given any input to the software, what is the expected result. So we do in that manner. Fourth is constructing test cases with selected inputs. And next foremost is executing those test cases. Like we construct the test cases by giving the selective inputs into it and then execute them. And then comparing actual outputs with the expected outputs. And then defects are fixed and retested. In all this black box testing, it is a simple way of testing only, but it differs from scenario to the scenario. In which we have to do it. Now comes tools which we used in black box testing. For QTP and Selenium, or we can say for regression testing or functional testing, we use the tool QTP and Selenium. And for any of non-functional testing, we use LoadRunner and JMeter. Then comes the testing techniques, like we do the testing in a certain method, but when we create test cases, we create any test scenarios, we do different techniques to find out any bug or any error. So there is a list of some of the techniques which we use in black box testing. Number one is decision table technique. As in its name, we say it is a table technique approach where various input combination or respective system behavior are captured in a table form or in a tabular form we do. Then comes the boundary value technique. In boundary value technique, we test, this is the second test, and in this we use the test to test the boundary values, you can say there is an upper limit or lower limit of a variable, and we test according to that, the boundary to one end to the other end. Then comes to the state transition technique. This technique is used to capture the behavior of the software application when any different input values are given to the same function. Like if there is any function to check the functionality of any feature, we give the two different value. Like for example, in a simple case, whenever we check for an email ad, like to a login to a certain page, we try different scenario like email address and then password. But whenever we give different values to the same function, like for the email login function, we give different values, either a given normal email or an incorrect email. So this is state transition technique. Then is all pair testing technique. All pair is to test all the possible discrete combination of values. This combination method can be used for testing the application. We can say that uses checkbox input or list box or text box, that kind of. Then comes cause effect technique. It underlines the relationship between a given result and all the factors affecting the result. So it is basically based on the collection of requirements, we can say. Then comes equivalence partition technique. It is very common technique in software technique testing, in which input data is divided into partitions of valid and invalid values. And it is mandatory that all partitions must exhibit the same behavior. Then comes the error guessing technique. As the name in itself is very clear, that it is a technique in which there is no specific method for identifying the error. So we can say on the basis of experience and the more you do many projects, so you keep guessing the problematic areas of the software and you use this kind of technique. Then is use case technique. It is used to identify the test cases from the beginning to the end of the system as per the usage of the system. So these are the major important kinds of techniques which is being used in the black box testing. Now comes the advantages and disadvantages. Like I already told you in the starting, there is gray box also and white box also. But for this black box technique, there is majorly advantage and some disadvantage also. So first advantage or pros is simplicity. Second is rapidity, and third is impartiality. I will just give you a brief idea what exactly this means. So if we talk about simplicity, it is a very simple kind of testing. No complex thing is in black box. Then comes the rapidity, or you can say this method is also non-intrusive. Then is rapidity. Rapidity in word means the preparation time for these kind of tests, like for black box kind of test, is very short. So little knowledge of the system is needed. So no much more major complexity in it. Then is impartiality. Impartiality, here are following a user point of view rather than a developer point of view. So the test results which we are getting are neutral. But this has also disadvantages also, like superficiality and redundancy. Superficiality, giving the fact that the code is not reviewed. So the test does not allow to see which parts of the code are the cause of the potential problem. So it is one of the, you can say, tests are there but less complete tests. And then is redundancy. This is I will give you an example. If other tests are made, so this one can lose its benefits since its range tends to be included in other tests also. Like I said, it is like not a complete test here. So if any tester involves certain amount of time and do one test, but if it does not end on giving the good software quality, so it bounce back, and then you have to perform different techniques for a different thing or for the same scenario a different technique. So it is kind of rebound, which is meant to be by this term.